This was racial malpractice that took Amber. We lost someone very, very, very important to us. Amber was the light to everyone's life. Her energy was just amazing. She was just so loving, so caring.
During the height of the COVID-19 pandemic, Amber Isaac lost her life while giving birth to her son.
You're ready for a bottle.
The fact that she never got to meet him really tears me apart.
Bruce McIntyre says his partner faced neglect at the Montefiore Medical Center in the Bronx.
This would not have happened if Amber was white. If Amber was white, she would still be here today. She would still be here.
According to McIntyre, red flags started to appear during Isaac's second trimester when she couldn't get an in-person appointment due to the pandemic.
In March, she was just getting like Zoom conferences, telehealth. They gave her a blood pressure monitor. She wasn't being seen that whole month. Amber's calling, reaching out, hey, I need the results back from the blood work. You know, the baby's due date is close. Nobody's reaching back out to us.
When Isaac received her test results, she learned that her platelet levels were dangerously low and was rushed to the hospital for an emergency C-section. Doctors learned Isaac had HELLP syndrome, a serious condition that affects the blood and liver. Days before going to the hospital, Isaac sent her final tweet, "Can't wait to write a tell-all about my experience during my last two trimesters dealing with incompetent doctors at Montefiore."
I said my goodbyes to Amber. I couldn't hug her, couldn't kiss her. I just had a try to talk her through it. She was scared, she was nervous. That was the last time I saw her. The last thing she had me doing was talking and singing to her stomach. That's what I did every night.
At age 26, Amber Isaac died during the C-section with no family members around her.
Amber Rose Isaac, it's such a sad story because of all the things that we know could go wrong, did. She advocated for herself and she still lost her life. These fractures in our healthcare system, this dismissing of Black women, of women in general, is causing death. Their symptoms not being listened to, being turned away, not being evaluated, not being taken seriously. Those small choices can be deadly for Black birthing people.
According to the CDC, Black women are about 3 times more likely to die of pregnancy-related causes than white women. About 60% of pregnancy-related deaths are preventable.
Really, our entire healthcare system has to be revamped so that we make sure that people like Amber Rose Isaac are seen and valued, especially as we move to more telemedicine and not in-person health, because that's here to stay. We need to ensure that we look at Amber Rose Isaac's case as an opportunity of learning of what we really need to do differently.
In a statement, the Montefiore Medical Center said 94% of our deliveries are minority mothers, and Montefiore's maternal mortality rate of 0.01% is lower than both New York City and national averages. Any maternal death is a tragedy.
I used to sing to him and everything, play the piano for him and Amber while he was in her womb, and he always heard music, right? Yeah, he always heard music.
In honor of Isaac, McIntyre started the Save a Rose Foundation to raise awareness about the racial inequality Black women face during pregnancy.
Amber was very big on her community. With Save a Rose, I want to do like a lot of community engagement. I'm working with Birth from the Earth right now. We just put together a scholarship program that offsets the costs of insurance premiums. So whatever insurance doesn't cover, this program covers, and that's in Amber's honor. We have to lead by example. You know, we have to fight for what's right. So that's all of the morals that I want Elias growing up with. Want him to carry that out throughout his lifetime. Everything that we're doing, I want him to be able to continue.
Be happy.
I'm going to go to the next slide. I'm going to go to the next one.
Thank you.